going to see the flexible bronchoscopy. Flexible bronchoscopy. So the flexible bronchoscopy is useful for the following: bronchoalveolar lavage, bronchial brushing, transbronchial biopsy, endotracheal biopsy, endoscopic ultrasound, endoscopic bronchial ultrasound, and final needle aspiration. So the bronchoscopy is an endoscopic technique that is, we put the endoscope through the mouth, the nose, or the tracheostomy. And in the flexible bronchoscopy, we use it for either a biopsy, taking biopsy, or to allow other procedures. So for example, in the bronchoalveolar lavage, this is done to obtain bronchial washing of the subsegmental bronchial after infusion of saline. And the indications for this are non-resolving pneumonia or diffuse pulmonary infiltrates in immunocompromised patients. Other indications include suspected alveolar hemorrhage or non-infectious diffuse lung diseases. The bronchial brushing, this is to obtain the sample of the bronchial tissue. The transbronchial biopsy, this is done to assess acute allograft rejection in lung transplant patients, also for lung nodules and infectious diseases in immunocompromised patients. So here we are taking an example of the lung. We are doing a biopsy, transbronchial biopsy. The endoscopic bronchial ultrasound, this is used for visualizing the walls of the airways, and indications are endoscopic bronchial endobronchial lesions, mediastinal lymphadenopathy, intrapulmonary nodules. So to assess diseases in immunocompromised patients, we usually do bronchoalveolar lavage if it is not infectious disease, and if it is an infectious disease, we do the transbronchial biopsy. And lastly, for the final needle aspiration, this is done to assess the mediastinal lymph nodes. So for flexible bronchoscopy, it is used or help to bronchoalveolar lavage, transbronchial biopsy, endoscopic bronchial ultrasound, final needle aspiration, bronchial brushing, and endotracheal biopsy.